Good morning, students. Our subject is Water Resources Engineering 1. We are in Unit 6. Present, our topic is Instantaneous Unit Hydrograph, IUH, and the conceptual models and regarding this NASH model. We are discuss this topic today. So guys, the instantaneous unit hydrograph, IUH, the definition and the properties. The instantaneous unit hydrograph is defined as a unit hydrograph produced by an effective rainfall of 1 mm and having an infinitesimal reference duration. In other words, the duration tends towards zero. In terms of the systematic conception, this means that the instantaneous unit hydrograph represents the response of the catchment to an instantaneous impulse. Of course, this is only a theoretical concept and cannot be realized in actual catchments, but it is useful as the instantaneous unit hydrograph can be analytically computed and on the basis of the S-curve. A certain unit hydrograph of any reference duration may be derived from it. Moreover, the instantaneous unit hydrograph can be related to the catchment geomorphology. It is reminded that the product of convolution of two mathematical functions is defined as f of g is equal t into 0 to the power of t into f of t minus I is g into t into dt, where g of t represents the intensity as a function of time t. F of t is the transfer function. Let S of t be the dimensionless ordinates of the time t of the S curve of a river basin. According to here, the ordinates of the unit hydrograph of duration t are given by the relation U of c is equal to t into S of t minus S of t minus small t, where U of t has the dimensions hours and minutes. S is dimensionless and t is the duration. The ordinates of the instantaneous hydrograph U naught corresponds to duration small t is equal to 0. Here, hence, t0 is equal to S of t minus S of t small t minus t by t, that is equal to d of S of t minus dt, and u naught t is equal ds by t by dt. Furthermore, the intensity function should be now defined. Let IE by t represent the effective rainfall intensity function that is multiplied by the area of the river catchment A and by the duration T in order to determine effective rainfall volume. According to here, the product A dot LE of T is equal U into T minus T dot T corresponds to the volume generated by the intensity LE of T. Integrating these elementary discharges over the duration of rainfall, the product of convolution is given by capital Q of t is equal to function 0 to t LE of t dot U of small t minus capital T dot dt. Here, guys, that is the equation time. Here t, this is a small t. I is the integrated unit dt. Here this figure is convolution of the intensity function with the interstitial unit hydrograph giving the discharge hydrograph. The boundaries of integration are capital T should not exceed the total duration of effective rainfall, that is zero or T into T. Small t minus t should not exceed the basic time of the unit hydrograph TB, that is zero less than or equal t minus t by TB. Hence, the following condition will be satisfied: 0 to t is equal TB plus t. The product of convolution allows for maintenance of the linearity and invariance hypothesis of the theory of the unit hydrograph. In the following paragraphs, instantaneous unit hydrograph resulting from different conceptual models are presented. Here, instantaneous unit hydrograph resulting from conceptual models. The conceptual unit hydrographs result from the representation of integration process of the effective rainfall as a cascade of reservoirs that fill and deplete according to certain laws. Let us consider one reservoir as presented in here in figure, that is characterized by three functions, that are the rate of filling T, the storage S of T, and rate of depletion duration Q of T. Here, LT, ST, and QT. Here, guys, this is figure 4.4 is a linear reservoir. The behavior of the function of this reservoir is ruled according to the following laws. Continuity law, ds by dt is equal to L of t minus Q of t. Storage law, S of t is equal to K naught Q of t, where K is the storage coefficient and it is constant, that confers to the reservoir the property of linearity. In effect, replacing here 4.2.2 in 4.21 in obtains K dot dQ by dt plus Q is equal to I. The solution of this equation is of that type Q is equal to MD by ND dot 1. Where M of D and N of D are the differential operations relative to the I and Q respectively. The ratio M of D by N of D is defined as the transfer function of the system. The methods for establishing above relations as proposed by several authors is discussed below. The instantaneous unit hydrograph of Nash. The instantaneous unit hydrograph proposed by Nash 1957 is a conceptual model that uses the effect of lamination of an effective rainfall having the depth of 1 millimeter and duration that tends towards zero. This lamination is performed by a cascade of n number of linear reservoirs having identical storage coefficient K. Here guys, P is equal to 1, Q1, Q2, Q of N plus 1 is equal, Qn is equal to Q of T. Here Q1 is equal T, Q2 R T, Qn is equal T. This figure 4.9, the Nash concept for deriving the instantaneous unit hydrograph. Here equation 4.23 may be written as dq by dt plus 1 by k into capital Q of t, that is equal 1 by k into L of t. Considering the equation of convolution, the expression of Q of t is Q of t is equal to function 0 to t L of t dot u of small t minus capital D dot dt. The integration of equation 4.25 is obtained by multiplying both terms from the right and left side with the t by k, e to the power of t by k, and one obtained small u into t minus capital T is equal 1 by k into e to the power of minus 1 by k into small t minus capital T. Thus, the output from the first reservoir becomes the input in the second one, and so on. Therefore, replacing small t minus t capital T by t yields that is equal L of t is equal 1 by k dot e to the power of minus the t by k. Again, the convolution equation allows for determining the output from the second reservoir that is equal Q of t is equal function 0 to t L of t dot u into t minus capital T into dt that is equal function 0 to t 1 by k into e to the power of minus t by k dot into 1 by k into e to the power of minus 1 by k into t minus t dot dt. So our Q of t is equal t by k square into e to the power of minus t by k. Reiterating the procedure of n reservoirs, the general expression of the ordinates of the Nash instantaneous unit hydrograph is obtained as Q of t is equal 1 by k of t to the power t of n into t by k n minus 1, that is e to the power of minus t by k, where t power n is the gamma function defined as t of n is equal function 0 to 0 to x to the power of n minus 1 dot e to the power of minus x into dx, where Vn is equal with the following iterative relation t of n plus 1 is equal to n into t of n. Relation 4.31 is the probabilistic phi function with 2 parameters. It is well known that the integral of the probabilistic distribution function is always equal to 1, which is the volume of the unit hydrograph. The increase time T of P and the peak discharge Q of P are derived by solving the equation dQ by dt is equal to 0 as follows T power P is equal K into N minus 1 and QP is equal 1 by k into t power n into n minus 1 to the power of n minus 1 into e to the power of 1 minus x. Finally, the ordinates of the instantaneous unit hydrograph might be expressed as a function of the increased time and the peak discharge as given below. Q of t is equal to Q of p into T by TP, that is e to the power of 1 minus n T by T into e power n minus 1. The instantaneous unit hydrograph derived by Nash is determined only as a function of 2 parameters, namely n and k. The influence of these parameters upon the shape and the magnitude of the hydrograph are presented in our 4.10. One observes that while the parameter n influences the shape of the hydrograph, the parameter k determines the position of the peak discharge. The higher the parameter k, the further the peak discharge is shifted with respect to abscissa, abscissa when the parameter n augments, the peak discharge q augments too. Since under the circumstances that T of P is kept constant, the increase of the parameter n corresponds to the diminution of the storage coefficient, and therefore the wave becomes sharper. Here guys, Q, N2, N1, N1 less than N2 and T. Here Q is equal TP less than P2, TP1 by TP2. Figure 4.10, sensitivity of the Nash model to the parameters N and K into T power P. Another example of the sensitivity of the Nash instantaneous unit hydrograph to the perimeter N while the storage K parameter is kept constant in presented in figure 4.11. Another example of the sensitivity of the Nash instrument instantaneous unit hydrograph to the parameter N while the storage K parameter is kept constant is presented in figure. Here guys, discharge 1 per second, here times in hours, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 hours. Here the meters per second, 0, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8. Here, guys, here red color indicates n is equal to, just like a pink color n is equal to 3, and delta n is equal to 4, circle n is equal to 5, here square n is equal to 7, dot n is equal to 10. The sensitivity of the Nash instantaneous unit hydrograph to the parameters n. By taking first order M1K, M10 and second order M2K, M2 capital Q, moments of the effective rainfall hydrograph and the resulting discharge hydrograph respectively, and taking into account the convulsion equation 4.20 and the analytical expression for the instantaneous unit hydrograph 4.25 Nash 1957 from the following relations between the parameters N, K and these moments. Here N, K is equal M1Q minus M1L. Here N of N plus 1 K square plus 2NK into M1K, that is equal MTQ minus M2H, where the moments are computed are as presented in figure here. NR delta T is equal H of T and capital T and NQ dot delta T. This is the capital T. The red line is the peak. This figure is the method of moments for deriving the instantaneous hydrograph. Moments of the hydrograph of effective rainfall and the hydrograph of the discharge were determined as follows. M1K is equal delta T by 2 dot sigma I is equal to 1 to NR bracket 2I minus 1 into H2 divided by sigma I is equal to 1 to NR HI. Here M1K is equal delta T square by 4 dot sigma I is equal to 1 to NR 2I minus 1 whole square dot H1 by sigma I is equal to 1 NR to H1. Here M1Q is equal delta T by 2 dot sigma NQ by I is equal to 1 2I minus 1, that is equal QI plus QI plus 1 by 2 divided by sigma I is equal to 1 NQ of QI plus QI plus 1 by 2. M1Q is equal delta T square by 4 into sigma I is equal to 1 to nq 2i minus 1 whole square dot qi plus 1 by 2 divided by sigma I is equal to 1 to nq qi plus 1 by 2. Here guys, where qi ordinate of the surface discharge hydrograph meters cube per second at time I is equal to 1 nq. Hi is equal depth of effective rainfall meters per second throughout the time interval delta t between the ordinates I and I plus 1. Nh, number of segments of the duration delta t of effective rainfall. Nq, number of ordinates the hydrograph has been split. Solution of the system of equation 4.31 gives the values of n and k. K is equal m2q minus m2k by m1q minus m1k minus m1q minus m1n. Here n is equal m1q minus m1k by k. Here variation in various of n and k determined by application of the method of moments to may flood events over a given catchment may be explained as follows. The method of moments induces errors in the estimation of m2q due to the errors of the discharge along the decreasing limb of the hydrograph. The term delta t square by 4 dot 2i minus 1 has a significant value because it is large. The event distribution of effective rainfall around the catchment is only an approximation. The unit hydrograph is considered a constant function of the basin, while actually it depends on the effective rainfall intensity, which will vary from one flood event to another. For this reason, the method of moments is jointly applied with an optimization procedure of the parameters that involves the following operations. Let us consider n pairs of hydrograph resulting in n pairs of parameters, n and k, by the method of moments. For each pair of j parameters, the ordinates of the instantaneous unit hydrograph are computed. Applying the S-curve method, the unit hydrographs specific to the considered reference duration are determined for all flood events. These unit hydrographs are multiplied by convolution with the corresponding effective rainfalls, resulting in computed hydrographs. The computed Qij of C and measured Qj of M hydrographs are then compared using a criteria function F as follows. Here F is equal to sigma I is equal to 1 to N, sigma I is equal to 1 to NQ of J, bracket Qij of whole to the power of M minus Qij of C whole square is equal to minutes, where NQJ is the number of the ordinates of each of hydrographs that is different from the number of effective rainfall segments of the reference duration. Thank you guys for this operation. I will explain the next loss in next topic.
Daddy,